Welcome again to the African Beat on the Voice of America. I am David Vandy, and today my special guest is from Nigeria. Well, this young man is somebody I've always admired, and a friend actually introduced his music to me. And one of his favorite songs that I like actually is Ibube. Well, I'm pretty sure you know who I'm talking about right now. So my guest on the beat today is Frank Edwards. Welcome to the African Beat, Frank.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Well, it's such a great pleasure having you here.
Yeah, I feel honored.
Well, let me tell you something. When I ran into you at the door, I was expecting some tall and huge guys. And that's the same thing people say to me all the time. Have you ever been told that?
Yeah, I get that a lot of times.
You get
that? Yeah, but...
Well, thank God you are here, and we're happy to have you on the show. So tell us a little bit about yourself. If people want to say, who is Frank Edwards? Give us a little background.
Well, Frank Edwards is a child of God, you know, a music minister, a producer, an entrepreneur, an achiever. I mean, I'm just out here to make a change in my generation.
Yeah. I like that. To make it in your generation. Yeah. So how did this all come about for you? Because for a young man like you to be a singer, a producer, an entrepreneur, and going around helping people. How did this all come about? How did this happen?
Well, I mean, it started from when I was young. You know, I grew up from this family. My family had it hard all the way. You know, we had to do tough things to be able to go to school, to be able to feed. You know, upbringing wasn't easy for my parents. So, and I just grew up wanting to help people not to go through the same thing I went through. You know, I just didn't want to see another child, you know, struggling on the streets, hustling just to be able to go to school, because then I wished someone paid my school fees. I wouldn't have to do all the things that I did.
You know, I was just going to ask you when you say tough things, and now you've started identifying some of the tough things, like going to school. You wanted to go to school and you wanted somebody to pay your fees.
Yes. I wanted someone to pay my school fees, but I mean, nobody was doing that, so I had to work as a child, you know, so I almost didn't have a childhood.
Wow.
So I didn't want another child to go through the same thing. So that's why I'm trying to do the things I do.
That's why you're doing what you're doing now.
Yeah.
Like we say here in America, no child should be left behind.
Yeah. Yeah.
No child should be left to suffer.
Yeah.
Because the parents cannot afford it, but... As a young man, you know, I admire the kind of courage that you have. So, when did you actually get into the music? Because if you were that little and you went through so much difficulties of how to make it in life, how to become who you are right now, how to be this Frank Edwards that everybody's admiring, everybody's talking about. So when did the musical part get into you? When did it actually start for you?
Well, you know, the musical part is God-given talent, because from age 7, I could already play the piano.
At 7?
Yes.
You're going to teach me that before you leave.
Yeah.
You're going to teach me that. I'm looking for a professional keyboardist in my church, so you're going to teach me that before
no
you
problem,
leave.
No problem. We'll talk about that.
So at 7, you started playing the keyboard?
Yeah, I started playing the keyboard.
And when did the singing come?
The singing didn't come not until 2013, thereabout.
2013?
Yeah.
And today Frank Edwards is all over the world.
No, is it 2000? No, like, sorry, 2007.
Okay, in 2007.
Yeah.
Okay. So when you started singing, did you find it difficult to have a breakthrough? What did mommy say? Because those days our parents would say, come on, singing? No way. I think you have to go back to school. If they can afford it, you have to be in school. You have to be a doctor. You have to be a lawyer. You have to be somebody bigger than just a singer.
Yeah, but what about when you don't have money to pay the school fees? Then you don't have a choice.
They know. Man, I like that. Yeah. That is so real.
Yeah.
Now, when you have to find something else to do.
Yeah. You know. So my dad would be like, oh, music. But my mom has always been very supportive. You know, she was the first person to invest in me setting up a mini studio.
Oh, wow.
You know, yeah, she supported. She was the one who gave me money. She had to sell her things to make up the money she gave me. And then, yeah, so she was a major part of it.
So when you got into this music, when mommy helped you to set up the first mini studio, did you start producing yourself immediately or did you start with other people?
No, I didn't start producing myself immediately, you know, because I belong to a place, a church, a ministry where my pastor was like my dad.
Okay, you know,
he was like a father to me. He made it possible for me to now learn how to produce music. You know, he brought people, paid them to teach me. So I started producing other people like Sinach. You know, I started producing.
So you started producing people like Sinach?
Yeah. Yeah.
And today, look at Sinach.
Yeah, you know, she's the biggest right now.
And you are such a blessing.
Yeah.
You know, and this is the same little boy that could not afford something to eat.
Yeah.
That could not go to school because the parents cannot afford to pay his school fees.
Yeah.
And this is the same boy that has grown up and has learned something that he's now imparting into other people, making them realize their God-given talent.
Yeah.
How does that make you feel?
It just makes me feel like God is good, and what he did for me, he can do for everyone else. So everybody, I just feel like everybody is a superstar. All they need is an opportunity.
It's an opportunity.
Yeah.
I like that word. Everybody is a star. All they need is an opportunity.
Yeah.
And when that opportunity knocks, just grab it
grab
and run
it,
away with
yeah.
it. You know, I was listening to your testimony. Before I ask you about your first song, I was listening to your testimony. You gave a testimony that is on YouTube. You know, I was listening to that testimony. You said the house you live in, I don't know if you still live in the same house, but the house you lived in at that time when you give that testimony, you know, when you walk out of the house, you stand around and look and ask yourself, how old are you, boy? And you living in this kind of a house, you know.
Yeah.
So tell me about that story.
It still happens. You know, it still happens. I still wake up every day to feel like, you know, I tap myself like, are you really here? Is this real? You know, because I couldn't imagine to where I was coming from. I grew up in a family of seven in a room apartment.
Wow.
In a very small room was my five siblings, my mom, my dad, all of us in that place. You know, so what God did and where he placed me, you know, every day I wake up, I look around all the things that God has blessed me with, and I'm thinking, like, what did you even do
to deserve
all this?
Wow.
You know, it's just the grace of God.
Wow. This is the African Beat on the Voice of America, and my guest today is Frank Edwards from Nigeria. He's a contemporary gospel artist, I'll say that, but he's going to tell us more about that. So stay close and don't go away. So let me come back to you, Frank. With your kind of music, who would you say you're targeting? I know, because normally when people of gospel orientation sing, they say you're targeting the church or who. But who are your target audience? Is it the same people that are already in church that they believe are already saved? Or are you looking for people that your songs can bless? Let me just leave that to you to explain.
Okay, actually, primarily, my music is not targeted to people. You know, my target is the heart of God. You know, because I feel like, you know, you say, if I be lifted up, I'll draw men to him. So I feel like if I target his heart, and when I get it, he has the responsibility of bringing all men to him. So I'm just trying to keep my worship pure. So my target is not necessarily the people, but when I hit my target, it hits every other person. So you see a lot of young people responding to the music.
To
you see a lot of, you know, elderly people responding to music. So I don't know how God does that. All I do is just target.
You just leave it to him.
Yeah.
So he makes the final decision.
Yeah.
I like that. Oh my God. Okay. You know, I talked to you about this, your song, Ebube. You know, I don't know. I need to get a complete interpretation of that song.
Yeah.
So tell me about that song, because I just love it. And anytime I listen to it, I feel it in my spirit. So tell me about that song.
You know, Ebube is an Igbo word that means glory. Ebube means glory. Ebube is glory. You know, so that song was and how the glory of God is reflected through us, His children. You know, see, look at my life and you see what God has done. Ebube means that the glory of God is reflecting through me. So when you look at me, what you see what is you see? Not really me, it's the glory of God that you see. You know,
wow. Yeah. Okay, all right, and that is awesome. And so, now how is Mama doing and how is the old man?
She is doing very well. My dad is doing very well. They are both happy, and my mom is happy she did what
it did. I want you to talk to her, especially Mama. I want you to look into that camera and talk to her. Tell her how you feel about her.
Well, Mom, if you're watching from everywhere, anywhere you are right now, yeah, this is me sitting here at Voice of America, the same boy you supported with 150,000 naira to set up a studio. Your seed has grown all over the world. So I'm not just the only one. Everybody who loves my music celebrates you. Everywhere my music is heard, your name is mentioned, whether you know it or not. And I love you very much. Thank you for what you did. Thank you for the sleepless night. Thank you for the endless love that still continues. And I mean, you don't need to be told I love you.
Wow. So Mama, I hope you watch that and you listen to that. This is a special love coming from your son to you. So now what are people expecting? What should people be expecting now from Frank Edwards? You've done all of this and everybody, you know, a lot of stars have passed through you. You know, we come to that. But what should people be expecting to come? Do we have any new works coming up that people should be looking forward to?
Yeah, you know, I have a new album coming in November. You know, I've been working on it for 3 years now.
You've been working on the album for 3 years?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just trying to get the sound right because we have to always do better every time.
Every time, yeah.
You know, so I've been working on it. But finally, it's going to be out in November. And then working on an album, Rocktown is trying to do an album for Nicole Mullen.
And Rocktown is your label, right?
Yes, yes.
You actually own that label?
Yes.
Okay.
So we're working on an album for Nicole Mullen. It's going to be from Nicole to Africa. You know.
Say that again?
From Nicole to Africa.
From Nicole.
To Africa,
to
yeah.
To Africa. Wow.
Yeah. I mean, Nicole Simulen, I mean, everybody knows her. And so we are doing that. And then we are raising a lot of other younger upcoming music ministers. We are empowering upcoming gospel music producers. So what I try to do is to do for them what my mom did for me.
Okay.
So I look for good upcoming gospel music producer and I set up a mini studio for them to see what they can make out of themselves from there.
Well, if I can ask you, I come from Sierra Leone, okay? And of course, Sierra Leone and Nigeria, we've got some very good relationship. We have some young gospel singers in my country. Do you only help those within your circle?
No,
or
no.
You also look out for people?
It's a global thing. It's not just in Nigeria.
So should I expect a step into my country?
Yes, if you have candidates, you can nominate somebody. If you send somebody to me, say this guy, and I look at them and they're good, we'll do the same thing.
Right.
So it's not just a Nigeria thing.
Okay, okay. Yeah. You know, this is great. And you've worked with a lot of other people, say from African singers to even to the Western world.
Yeah.
So how many, you know, I'm not saying how many, but just give me a few of the people that you've actually graced.
I've worked with Don Moen. Mm-hmm. In fact, we actually have an album together.
Okay.
We have a whole album together. It's called The Grace Project. You know, it's everywhere now online. It's called The Grace Project, Frank Edwards and Don Moen. You know, I've worked with Micah Stampley.
Yes, Micah.
Yeah, okay. I've worked with Micah Stampley. You know, of course, I've worked with Nicole. I've worked with Cheval Franklin. And I have a lot of them in the new album.
In the new album
that
coming
I don't
up.
Just want to unveil.
okay. We can leave it at that.
Yeah.
We can leave it at that. But you know, what was it like working, bringing up people like Sinaj, producing people like Sinaj, and you see Sinaj today? Wow, she's.
I feel like she's the one who brought me up.
She's the one who actually brought you up.
Yeah, because what I was doing then was, you know, she writes the music and she calls me. I play the keyboard. Then, Frank, I wrote a new song. Come, let's produce it. And I go and I'm helping. So in the process of working with her, I was learning.
You were learning.
I feel like that's where the singing thing happened to me because I didn't know I could sing.
But that was a connection, right?
Yeah, that was a connection. So every time I worked with her, sometimes Sinat is a complete musician. So you're working with her, she already has in her mind what she wants to hear. And then I'm playing, she'd be like, Frank, can we do the strings line like this now? Because it's difficult. I would tell her, no, that doesn't sound good. But she will insist until I do it, now I know it.
Okay.
You know, so that's how I actually grew in music production and everything.
And yeah. I'm looking forward to having her also on the show because I understand she's coming to the U.S.
It will be amazing.
Yes,
I'm looking
forward to having her. But like I told you, we have to make time that anytime you come back next, I understand you're not going to be staying for long, but anytime you come back next, we have to do another studio interview where we'll see you actually performing your songs in the studio. How about that?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
All right.
We'll do that.
Well, it's so great. I just want you to send a message to the I know you like you say, you don't target the people, you target the heart of God and God will do the rest.
But
there are people,
I know people
there
yeah.
who are looking up to you,
yeah,
who
yeah.
are expecting to hear from you. So what would be your message to them?
Well, my message to everybody who love my music, who are inspired by my music, and looking up to me to be able to do the same thing or even more, keep the dream alive. Everybody's a superstar. You know, just be ready for your opportunity so that when it comes, you don't miss it. When it comes, you're ready for it. You know, study, update yourself, learn what you need to learn, because you don't know when your opportunity will come. But as for shining, you're already a star. Just when your opportunity comes, just grab it and shine.
Yeah. All right. Well, I just want to say thank you so very much. This has been a pleasure, and you know, talking here to you, sitting with you at the Voice of America on the show today. It's wonderful to have you, and I look forward to receiving more of your albums. Now you have the platform. You guys, you're going to have my emails. If the songs are coming out, just all what you need to do is just let your whoever your producer is, just send it songs to me, and definitely we'll air them. And whatever part of the world you are, we can call you and we can just talk about it.
Oh, wow.
But whenever you come in, we definitely make time for studio.
Oh, wow.
All right? Definitely. So thank you so very much.
Thank you so much.
It's been a pleasure
talking
to you.
Thank you so much.
All right. Well, that's all we have for you today on the show. That was my one-on-one sit-down interview with Nigerian gospel artist Frank Edwards. In fact, right now, we're going to change that whole thing about Nigeria. We're going to make it a worldwide thing. He's a man of the world and he's a man of Africa. We in Africa, we're so proud of Frank, and we always want you to be around. So thank you very much, and thanks for joining us on the show today. I am David Vandy, and I love to say bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, bro.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.